Today I'm showing you the AI features of this new browser, but know that it is packed with non-AI awesome features that will make your browsing experience so awesome. This new browser is called Aria, and once you tried it, it makes Chrome, Edge, and Firefox like a thing of the past. Let's dive into it. The first thing I want to show you is the sidebar on the left side that gives you access to a bunch of AI features. Now, before I get to the AI features, just know that you also have access to social media like WhatsApp, Instagram, but we're gonna focus on the AI stuff right now. The first one is Aria, and Aria is Opera's own version of ChatGPT, sort of. And this is completely free, and I've been trying it before, and it's pretty good. And we will jump into it right after I show you all the different buttons. The next one is ChatGPT. Of course, everyone knows ChatGPT, but how awesome it is to have it right next to where you are browsing. So a lot of times I have a tab open for ChatGPT, but then if you are anything like me, you open like 20 or 50 tabs and then it gets lost. So this is super cool to have access to it right there. You also have access to ChatSonic. Now, I've just used ChatSonic a couple of times, but I don't know it that much and I don't know how good it is, but I heard only good things online. So know that you have access to it here. All right, so another way you can access Aria is by using the shortcut Command/ on a Mac and maybe Control/ on a Windows machine. And so the first thing I wanted to know is how Aria differs from ChatGPT. So I prepared this prompt, which is, what are the your specificities compared to ChatGPT? Can you give concrete examples? So let's see what it says. Now, the first thing to know is that it is way slower than ChatGPT to answer. And you can see it right away. It takes a lot of time to answer. Hopefully they improve that in the future. So here they claim that it is specifically designed to answer those topics, science, technology, history, and current events. But honestly, when I read between the lines, what I see is it's exactly like ChatGPT with web access. And so we can try it and we can ask this question: who was number one in the NBA draft 2023? And normally it should have access to the internet to figure this out. The San Antonio Spurs selected Victor Wembanyama with the number one overall pick. But if you go to ChatGPT directly here in ChatGPT-4, you can browse the internet using Bing, and I could ask the same question, and most likely it will know the answer as well. Interestingly enough though, and that's a good point for Aria is faster when it comes to information online. So that's a good point for them. Another awesome features I wanted to show you is an AI prompt button that is located right here in the address bar. And for some reason, they disabled it in the last couple of days. And so I cannot show it to you right now, and it sucks. But I'm gonna show you a flavor of what this button can do in a second. But before that, let me explain what this button is for. So hopefully you will have that AI prompt button by the time you download Aria, and I'm sure they're gonna put it again in a couple of days. So awesome. When you click on it, you have the option to summarize the page. And oftentimes I go to an article and it's just so long, I don't have time to read it all. So you click in one click, you can summarize it, and it basically sends that article to Aria and it summarizes it for you. Or you can even ask what are the main points of that article, or you can ask to translate that article if it is in different language, or if you want to read it in a different language. You can also ask to create a tweet out of that article. This feature is absolutely awesome. And again, it's such a bad timing that I'm not able to show it to you, but you get the gist of it. And how it works is this: there's this other features that you have in Aria, which is whenever you select some text on an article, you have these buttons that appear that are explain briefly, explore topic, and translate. And what the AI prompt button I'm talking about is basically exactly this, except that instead of doing it on the selected text, it does it on the entire page, which is much more useful in a way. So if I click here on explain briefly, you can see that it sends that paragraph to Aria, and then Aria does the explanation. One thing to note is I've been using this for Aria browser for the last couple of months, and before it was ChatGPT, the default LLM for summarizing the article. And I always prefer ChatGPT when it comes to LLM because we all know it's the best one out there for now. So it's kind of a shame that you cannot change the default, but I get it. They want to push their own LLM. And to be honest, it's free, so why not? But hopefully it will get better in the future and a bit faster. So here you summarize it, but I can also translate it and I can just click on this, which language you want to translate it to, and I can choose Spanish. And then it's going to translate that little paragraph into Spanish. So let me touch briefly on some other awesome features, even if they are not AI related, just so that you have an overview of what you can do with it. They created those, what they call island tabs. And what this is some groups of tabs that you can create. And here I have two pages related to AI. And here I have the script for this video in another island. And it makes it super neat to organize your tab like this. And I really like the style that they gave to it. Another cool feature is the ability to take snapshot of a selection or the entire page that you are looking at. And this is obviously possible in Chrome or any other browsers as well, but you would need to install an extension. So here it's kind of cool that you have that by default. Another thing you have by default is this block ads or even VPN that you can have integrated into the browser itself. So I think it's just so awesome, and they packed a bunch of other features. And honestly, when you use it, try it yourself. But when you try to get back to Chrome or Firefox, Edge, Safari, you name it, it just feels like something is missing. It feels like not modern and you want to go back to Opera. So they did an amazing job. Now there are some issues that they have right now. See, with the AI prompt button I was talking about, hopefully they will fix this in the future. But other than that, I think you should definitely use it. It's free. So hopefully it will be another tool that you add in your toolbox.